All right, Celeste.
Okay.
Fertilizer mixing, and guess what? Math is involved.
Yes, lots of numbers and math when we're talking about fertilizers. Darn it.
Got it. Hey, math has to come in handy somewhere, right?
It does, but you know, it's not hard math.
Okay.
So we're doing some basic, you know, junior high math skills, nothing too difficult.
Okay.
We're gonna do a little division, a little multiplication, and we're good to go. So
I think I can handle that then.
Yeah.
All right. So what do you want to start with this? I see you have fertilizer here.
Oh, yeah, we got several places we can start.
Okay.
You want to start with talking about the parts of fertilizer?
Let's do that.
Okay. Well, your fertilizers are going to have three numbers that are denoting what type of fertilizer they are.
Okay.
That's known as the fertilizer analysis, okay? So, for example, 3400 is the bag I have right here beside me. The first number is the amount of nitrogen that you have in that fertilizer. The second number is your phosphorus. The last number is your potassium.
Right.
And a lot of old timers know potassium is potash.
Potash,
so it
yeah.
gets a little confusing
uh-huh.
when you're talking about that. People think phosphorus is potash, but it's not. So we've got nitrogen first, phosphorus, then potassium.
N, P, and K.
N, P, and K, for short, if you wanted to sum that up. It is called the fertilizer analysis, but it can also be looked at as a ratio or a percentage. So these numbers are telling you the percentage that's in this bag of each ingredient.
Okay.
So 3400 has 34% nitrogen in this bag, and it's got 0% phosphorus and potassium. For example, there are some other types out there that people may be familiar with. We have on the table here triple 13.
Mm-hmm.
If you looked at that in a ratio form, that would be a 1:1:1 because all three numbers are the same.
Right.
So you've got 13% nitrogen, 13% phosphorus, 13% potassium. And hopefully I've described that well enough to make sense.
Yeah, that makes sense. 1:1:1 ratio.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, so we have triple 13, or we have, how about 15-5-15? Okay, let's start with that. So if only 45% of 15-5-15 is actual fertilizer, what is the remaining portion?
Okay, so the remaining portion that's not talked about on your fertilizer analysis, that is going to be what they call inert material.
Right.
It's a filler. It's usually going to be made of clay or something organic in, you know, in that form that fertilizer is able to be mixed with. And you would think, well, I'm getting cheated. I'm not getting all I'm paid for.
Right.
But really, it does have a few purposes. Number one, it helps owners be able to apply it more efficiently, get better coverage, and it also prevents overapplication of fertilizer. So farmers buy fertilizer in bulk, and that doesn't have filler in it. Bagged fertilizers are going to have this inert material, and it just makes it more efficient for homeowners to be able to use it properly.
Okay, inert ingredients
inert.
Is pretty much what you see on the bag.
Yeah.
All right, so how about this one? What's the difference between complete versus incomplete fertilizer?
Okay, well, we have some perfect examples.
Okay.
The 3400 that we talked about, that would be considered an incomplete fertilizer because it only has one ingredient. It doesn't have all three ingredients in the fertilizer, okay? Now, anything else that has a number in every one of those slots would be considered a complete fertilizer, like a triple 15, or 15, 15, 15. People shorten it for short and say triple 15. Or the triple 13 that we have on the table as well. Those would be considered complete fertilizers.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
There are also some other ways that you could categorize fertilizers. You could categorize them in as, as slow release or fast release. These both would be considered a fast-release fertilizer. They're going to release their nutrients over a 2 to 3 week period, and they're usually going to look kind of like crushed up rock, you know, just for a general appearance. Slow-release fertilizers are in more of a, it's called a prill. It's a small, smooth, round type ball. and those are going to release their nutrients over a 2 to 3 month period.
Okay.
So,
like Osmocote.
Right, like Osmocote would be considered a slow release. And they make it in large bags as well.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got a lot of different options, and different circumstances call for slow, and some you may want to go ahead with fast release. So those are a few different ways that we can divide fertilizers up into. And you could also go water-soluble or insoluble. A water-soluble fertilizer would be something that's in a crystal form, kind of like Miracle-Gro, that you can pour into water and it goes into solution. You can water your plants with it. So that's a few different ways that you could talk about fertilizers.
Okay. Now let's definitely talk about this one while we have a little time left. Organic sources of N, P, and K, because you know, of course, a lot of folks want to grow their vegetables organically, so let's give them some organic sources for N, P, and K.
We definitely have sources for organic nutrients. The only issue with that is usually they're going to have less of that nutrients in them, so you'll have to use more of it than you would synthetic fertilizers. They're also a little more expensive, but we've got a couple examples here. This first one is blood meal. This would be a source for nitrogen, organic source for nitrogen. This particular one here, I think, has 12% nitrogen. Okay. So obviously, that's not even half of the synthetic 3400, but it's available. Also, here we've got bone meal. That's a good source for phosphorus. It does have a little nitrogen in it as well. This particular brand has 2% nitrogen, 14% phosphorus, and 0% potassium. Okay. So it's mainly a phosphorus source. Now the third ingredient, your potash or potassium, I don't have an example of it here, but that would be products that are made from seaweed or kelp or even burnt wood ashes. You can get some nutrients in the form of potash in that way. They're usually going to be between 4 and 10% active ingredient in those products. So they are available and on the market.
Okay. Again, these are your organic sources. So these do work.
Yes.
Okay. And yes, they are good.
Yeah. And they're good. I mean, this is what folks used, you know, before we had synthetics. So if you are trying to promote organics and try to go in that direction, you can definitely do that with those products.
All right, Celeste, we appreciate that good information, and you're going to be with us next week to show us how to apply these fertilizers.
Yes.
All right, thank you.
Okay, thanks. All right.